Can the guru change the karma of a person? When does that happen?
If the guru alone can change the karma of a person, he can change everybody's karma in one stroke. No. You have to do your some effort also. And guru definitely can relieve you from your sins. When you realize you made a mistake and there is a sin, you can't relieve yourself of sin. Definitely guru can do it for you. In that sense, yes. At the same time, you have to do purusharth, your self-effort, and to do good work. The good work you need to do. And the sense of devotion and love and devotion, that is equally proportionate to the amount of karma that gets released.
ഗുരുജി, എൻ്റെ ഭീരുത്വം കൊണ്ട് എല്ലാ പ്രതിസന്ധികളിൽ നിന്നും ഞാൻ ഒളിച്ചോടുന്നുണ്ട്. എങ്ങനെ ഇതിനെ തരണം ചെയ്യും? ബിക്കോസ് ഓഫ് മൈ കാഡ്ലി ബിഹേവിയർ, ഐ റൺ അവേ ഫ്രം ഓൾ ദ ചലഞ്ചസ് ഇൻ ലൈഫ്. ഹൗ ക്യാൻ ഐ കം ഔട്ട് ഓഫ് മൈ കാഡൈസ്?
ഫസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ഓൾ, യു നോ, if the challenge is there in front of you, you also have the power to face it. You should recognize you have the power, you have the energy to face it. With this conviction you move. Okay, I am with you.
Guruji, pidru tarpanangalkkum sheshakriyagalkkum endengilum adisthanam undo? ഇത് ശുദ്ധ അസംബന്ധമല്ലേ?
എന്താ?
പിതൃതർപ്പണങ്ങൾക്കും ശേഷക്രിയകൾക്കും എന്തെങ്കിലും അടിസ്ഥാനമുണ്ടോ? ഇസ് ദർ എനി ബേസിസ് ഫോർ റിച്വൽസ്? പിതൃതർപ്പണം,
യു നോ, ദീസ് റിച്വൽസ് ആർ ദേർ ഓൺലി ടു ഷോ യുവർ ഗ്രാറ്റിറ്റ്യൂഡ് ഫോർ ദ ഡിപ്പാർട്ടഡ് സോൾസ്. ബട്ട് വാട്ട് ഹാസ് ഹാപ്പൻഡ് ഇസ് the pandits, the rituals, purohits have made it so complicated. Sometimes you don't understand what they're saying. You know, if they translate what they're saying in Sanskrit and simply give you, it gives you an idea. Why we take sesame seed and give it tarpayami. It's called tarpanam. You take their name and take a sesame seed and with water you pour it on a plate. Why you do this? You tell them, those departed souls, whatever desires you might be harboring in your mind, it is like a sesame seed. It's insignificant, small thing. You just drop it. There is infinite joy and bliss where you are in the abode of divine. Just enjoy it. These things we will take care. Your unfulfilled desires, unfinished job in this planet is like a sesame seed. That we will take care of it. You have contentment. You be happy. You move in contentment. This is what we tell them in that tarpanam. For the departed souls. Say, mother, father, I know you had some desires. You know, they do have desires. They want to see the marriage of the grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and see great-grandchildren getting one more daughter. These sort of desires do remain in their mind before they die. So we tell them, look, these desires are small. Drop them. Love is the essence of life. And the divine is all love. So you move on to the light, which is all love. So giving instruction to the departed soul is what Shraddha. And then ask them blessing. From there, okay, I will do my part. What you can do from there, you give me blessing, that so that my mind will be in the right track. so that I do good things, right things in the right time. Bless me with good luck, prosperity. See, this type of shraddham is all over the world. Even in South America, they do this. One particular day, they say, the entire city comes on this road. They do it in one day. That's all for ancestors. They burn big effigies or many things they burn on the street. In China, they do. In Singapore, they do. You know what they do in Singapore? There is a particular day for ancestors. Whatever the ancestors were passionate about, they make those things in the paper and they burn them. You know, they make, if their father loved car, they make a nice car, Benz car, keep it on the street of Singapore and burn it. And one day you see that whole Singapore, it's a clean and neat city. One day in a year it will be so dirty. Because everywhere you find papers and loads of paper being burnt. And the faith there, the belief there in China is when you burn some fake currency, it's a fake currency note you burn, it reaches them and they'll give you good luck and give you... Sometimes I feel it's cheating. But at the same time, it is just the faith, you know. They build big homes right in the middle of the street and they burn it so that the blessing will come from the other side. They'll bless you with home, they'll bless you with whatever you need. That sort of connecting to the people on the other side is what is Shraddha. So it's called Shraddha, faith. With faith, honoring people who have crossed over to the other side. So this in Europe also there is the All Saints Day. There is one day the people go and offer flowers in the burial grounds. This is there. That Shraddha is there in almost all religion, in all culture. Shraddha. Here this is very meaningful in Sanskrit, but people don't understand this. Like a pindadana, they put a ball of rice. See, our body has come out of a ball of food. Isn't it? So you keep a ball of food. And whatever they had liked, some good food, you cook and you make it and in their memory give it, feed it to other people, the poor people. Others. That is the Shraddha, is to be done with a sense of gratitude and sense of celebration, remembering the ancestors. Yeah, this much you can do. In memory of them, feed few people, make food which they liked and eat and enjoy. Thank them and wish them progress in the world where they are and ask for their blessings. Give me blessings so that I do my journey here well. That's it.